Why might my internet connection randomly stop working? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. I've got 8 things for you to look at to help diagnose why you might have a flaky internet connection. Unfortunately, there are enough things that could be wrong or affecting your internet that I can't tell you which one applies to you. But these are the things that I would look at if it were happening to me. Number one, or really number zero, is that I'd reboot your router. Pull the plug, let it sit for 30 seconds, plug it back in. There's a reason so many tech support answers start with reboot the device, unplug it and plug it back in again. It's a meme, let's face it. The fact is that that can reset a lot of things in the device back to a working state. Routers tend to be left on all the time, which means that they're accumulating days, weeks, months of randomness, if you will, as they do their job. Sometimes, not often, but sometimes, that can be enough to cause it to slow down or get confused and just sort of have random behavior. So that definitely is where I would start you. Now, on to the other issues that are a little bit less obvious and a little bit harder to deal with. Number one is router overload. It's interesting, especially with older routers. Routers are just computers, like any other computer, to be honest. There's a CPU inside, there's an operating system, there's RAM, there's all sorts of stuff. The bottom line, though, is that the router that you got maybe 5-10 years ago that's been working fine ever since might not be as powerful as a router that you would get today. That then implies that we're also throwing more things at our internet connection. 10 years ago, it was like 3 computers in my house and we were done. Now it's 4 computers, I think, a bunch of IoT devices, a bunch of streaming services, TVs and Rokus and so forth. Basically, I've got something like 40 devices connected to my internet. That means my router has to work harder at providing the internet connection. Sometimes that can have an effect of intermittent problems. So one of the things to look at is basically think about just how much is your router really working these days. In that same vein, number two is router overheating. This happens for a couple of reasons. One is overwork, right? If you have a router and you go to it and touch it and it just seems super hot, that can be a problem. The real scenario, though, that tends to cause this more often than anything else is that the router itself requires airflow. It needs air to be able to flow through and around it in order to keep it cool. If that's become blocked off, either because of where you happen to put your router or because of the things in life, like corgi fur around here, have accumulated in front of your router's vents, that can cause it to overheat. So make sure it's got airflow, make sure that the vents are clean of whatever might be in the way. Number three, router bugs. Like I said, routers are just computers, special purpose computers, but computer nonetheless. They run software. All software has bugs. Therefore, you might be running into situations now that are exposing potential bugs in the router's own software. That's an easy one to check for, not whether or not it has bugs, but whether or not there's updated firmware for your router. The way to do that is to go to the router manufacturer's website and see if there are updates available for your specific model, and then follow their instructions to basically install that update on your router. Number four, too many devices accessing the internet at once. I'm good here that I've got 40 devices all connected, but the majority of them are very short, very quick internet access kind of devices. For example, my light switch, my IoT light switch, the only time it deals with the internet is when I'm turning something on or off, or when maybe my Amazon device is trying to determine the state of the switch to show me whether it's on or off. On the other hand, if I'm streaming on my PC and I'm streaming on a couple of TVs and I'm doing some other heavy downloads on yet another machine, it is possible that I could overwhelm my router simply by the sheer amount of data that I'm trying to push through it at the same time. That is something that you can at least keep in mind when you're experiencing problems. When you're experiencing problems, check the other machines. Check what's going on with your internet connection and see if it simply might be a case of too much data all at once. Number five, Wi-Fi signal strength and interference. So far, I've been talking specifically about your router and what it does connected to your internet. Wi-Fi is kind of its own special little beast. It's radio. And essentially what that means is there are Wi-Fi specific things that can impact your Wi-Fi connectivity. Those include the distance between your computer connected to Wi-Fi and the Wi-Fi antenna. Frequency channel and channel interference. If you've got a bunch of devices that are using Wi-Fi and they're all using the same channel, that can also result in slow, intermittent connections. There are both frequencies to choose from, 2.4 gigahertz and 5 gigahertz, but even within those frequencies, there are channels that you can look at. There are devices and techniques that will allow you to determine what the optimum channel is for your situation. Electrical interference from other devices turns out to be a big one, especially in the 2.4 gigahertz range, because there are devices that use the 2.4 gigahertz range. Specifically, cordless landline phones. Some of them do use 2.4, and if you receive a phone call and your internet connection drops, guess what? That may very well be the issue. Also, other devices like microwave ovens often throw out a lot of electrical noise, a lot of radio noise. That too can impact almost anything that's wireless that's in proximity. Signal blockage from large pieces of metal. This one is a little bit harder to identify, but if there's something large and metallic between your machine and your antenna, that can cause interference. The one that's a little bit sneaky is that many buildings, often office buildings, are now being built using aluminum or metal structure. They use, instead of using wood 2x4s here in the United States, they have these aluminum things that are lighter, and I don't know if they're stronger or whatever, but they're metal. And they're arranged in a grid depending on where you are and how the building is constructed and how far away that Wi-Fi access point is. Even the building you're in can interfere with what you're doing. And finally on this side, antenna size. They say size doesn't matter, but that's absolutely wrong when it comes to antennas. If you have the opportunity to put appropriate replacement antennas on either or both your access point, the antenna on your router or on the Wi-Fi access point, and or you have the option to attach a different antenna or a larger antenna to whatever wireless device you're using, that too can help improve your ability to receive a wireless signal. Number six, other hardware issues. A surprisingly common problem for wired connections is the cable. It's not uncommon for cables, especially if they've been in use for some time, to get stepped on, to get chewed on, to get bent in weird shapes, all that kind of stuff. They can continue to work or appear to work, but at some point they can get to like the verge of not working. That can manifest as intermittent connectivity. The way to deal with that, it's an easy one, replace the cable. Get a new one, plug it in, and see if that doesn't help the issue. Number seven, software issues. I've not talked about anything actually on any of the computers except for your Wi-Fi. If you're using a VPN, if you are using security software that is doing some special things to monitor your internet connection, if you've got a firewall, there's so many different things that can be running on your PC that could interact with your internet connection that it's worth understanding what those are. Like I said, VPN is an obvious one. It's essentially an internet connection over your internet connection. Your security software can sometimes actually try and get itself into the internet connectivity in such a way that it can keep you safe from things coming down the wire. But it can also add problems of some sort. Firewalls, of course. Normally, this isn't something you have to look at, especially in recent versions of Windows. The Windows firewall is actually pretty good. It's not really having the problems that older firewalls used to have. But if there's a firewall, could be a problem. And of course, incorrect network settings can manifest in all sorts of odd kind of ways, including intermittent connectivity. One approach to dealing with this latter one is to actually go to Device Manager, locate the device, the network device that you're talking about that you're having problems with, and remove it from Device Manager. That is one of the ways, one of the standard ways, that forces Windows to reload the driver and reset the settings for that network connection. That sometimes can make things better. Number eight. We have to be realistic about this. It is possible that your ISP could be having a problem. One of the things to do, and I've run into this myself, I've had internet connectivity problems here at home, but one of the first things I do is I go check out my internet provider's website, often like using my mobile phone and its mobile connection as opposed to my home internet connection, which might not be working. It's not uncommon for them to actually have status that says, hey, sorry, we know there's a problem. We're working on it. And here's an ETA. Sometimes, depending on your ISP, you may need to call them and ask them if something is up or if there is something specific about your connection that they can identify as being the problem. But those are the things to look at. Connectivity issues can be super, super frustrating. I get that. And it's unfortunate that it's this way. But hopefully now you've got a few things to look at, a few things to check, at least a few things to understand, to help, hopefully, diagnose your internet connectivity problems. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/169894. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.